Let's talk about Washington, D.C. for a second. I've worked here for about 20 years, live here with my wife and kids, and though I'll root for the Phillies until my last dying breath, Washington is my home. It's also home to my friend Mark Leibovich, who's covered politics for a while and is now the chief national correspondent for the New York Times. Leibovich has a new book dropping today about Washington. It's called This Town, Two Parties and a Funeral, Plus Plenty of Valet Parking in America's Gilded Capital. Let's listen to how he describes it. He says, this is a city that is so interconnected, a city of beautiful, busy people constantly writing the story of their own lives. It's far from being hopelessly divided. It's, in fact, hopelessly interconnected, he writes. So, Mark, are you there?
I'm here. Can you hear me?
So you and I, you and I usually, when we're at these cocktail parties that you satirize so so ably, so you skewer so ably in this book, you're usually on the side, you and I talking about how crazy it is. And now you've written an entire book about it. Now, I know why I love this book, because I know everybody in it. But explain to our viewers, why should they read this book? Why would they care?
I actually do think that this book is aimed at people outside of Washington. I mean, obviously, there's been a lot of anticipation and a lot of speculation and a lot of, you know, tidbits taken inside the Beltway. But ultimately, I want people outside of Washington to know what the city that I think they fundamentally are disappointed in truly has come to. And the fact is, it's a very, very gilded age in Washington right now. And I wanted to sort of flesh out what the full carnival has really looked like and what America is paying for.
And it's a lot of connections and people paying for connections and people trafficking on connections and cashing in on those connections. What of all the things you describe in this book, what bothers you the most? Is it the politicians who leave Capitol Hill and then become lobbyists? Is it the people who completely sell out their ideals? What gets under your skin the most when it comes to the things about D.C. that bother you?
I think I would sort of put, what I would say now is that the level of outrage has sort of reached a low point. I mean, people just expect that when people are running for Congress, they will run against Washington as a swamp. Then they will get here and settle into the place like a warm bath. After they leave office, they'll get a job and lobby or something, even though they've vowed that they wouldn't lobby. I mean, there's a level of you can say something, you cannot really mean it, and, well, that's just the game. It's the way the game is played in Washington. And I guess, I mean, that's sort of a weird answer to your question, but just it's the non-outrage. It's the fact that we have become resigned to a certain way of doing business here.
You describe President Obama in the book as somebody who has a lot of disdain for this town, but as somebody who is completely part of a system whose own insiders traffic in the same compromises, the lobbying ban, you know, out the window. But he somehow doesn't seem to be blamed for what all of these aides around him cashing in are doing.
Well, I mean, I think, look, Barack Obama was an incredibly, his message of hope in 2008 and change was incredibly powerful and incredibly resonant, especially in that time. And ultimately, as the president of the United States, I mean, first of all, the presidency exists on a plane that I could not even begin to understand. I mean, that's almost its own separate history. But ultimately, there have been these series of neverminds in this campaign and this administration, whether it's we're not going to opt out of the campaign finance system, they opt out of the campaign finance system, we're not going to work with super PACs, they work with super PACs, we're not going to let lobbyists into the White House, and so forth. Eventually, it wears you down. And I do think that ultimately, a lot of the Washington insiders that got him elected but said they weren't of this world have really sort of settled in nicely.
All right, Mark Leibovich, author of This Town, a very enjoyable read. Thanks so much for talking to us. We'll see you soon on our political roundtable, I hope.
Thanks, Jake. I appreciate it.